Hello and welcome to today's video. Today, let us discuss some aspects on nucleus. Nucleus is the controlling center of a cell. Here, it controls all the activities of a cell and also our genetic or hereditary material is stored inside this nucleus. There are different components of the nucleus like nuclear envelope, which is the covering of the nucleus, and then the nucleoplasm and nucleolus, followed by chromatin. These are the components present in the nucleus: nuclear envelope, nucleoplasm, nucleolus, and the chromatin. First, this is the ultrastructure of a nucleus. Here, this is the nuclear envelope. This is the nuclear envelope, and the envelope or the membrane is double layer. And inside this, we have a gel-like fluid or gel-like matrix inside this nucleus that is called the nucleoplasm. And inside the nucleoplasm, we have a thick and granular region which is called nucleolus, and thin thread-like substances we can see extending here, and these are the chromatin. So these much things the nucleus has, and outside you can see some flower like or thin structures outside on the nuclear membrane. These are the nuclear pore complexes. So nucleus has a nuclear membrane and a gel like substance or the fluid which is filled inside is called nucleoplasm, and have a granular region which is the nucleolus and the chromatin. And in the nuclear membrane they have certain pores, and these pores are associated with certain proteins which together form the nuclear pore complex. Then here in this figure you can see the details. This is the first component, nuclear membrane. This is the nuclear membrane and it is double layered. This is the outer membrane and this is the inner membrane. In between there is a space, and this space is called the perinuclear space. And the nuclear membrane is closed. You can see it is connected here. The inner and outer membranes are connected, they are joined or closed. They are closed in the regions where the nuclear pore is present. In every pore regions, the nuclear outer and inner membranes are closed. You can see in this figure. So, these are the pores, nuclear pores. And the space between inner and outer membrane is called the perinuclear space. And these thin thread-like structures, they are the chromatin. And here you can see the nucleolus, and this is the annulus. First component is the nuclear membrane. Nuclear membrane is a lipid bilayer, say the same as that found in the plasma membrane or any other membrane of the cell organelles. It has an outer membrane and an inner membrane. The nuclear envelope is a double layer membrane which is perforated with several pores. And why do they need a pore? These pores help in the communication or transport of materials in and out of the nucleus. So that is the function of nuclear pores. The outer layer or the outer membrane of nucleus is connected with the endoplasmic reticulum, which is communicating with the cytoplasm. So, functions of a nuclear membrane are: it gives shape and stability to the nucleus, it helps in compartmentalization, that is it separates the nuclear contents from the cytoplasmic contents, and then the regulation of substances, it allows certain substances to pass through the membrane. So, it maintains a regulation of transport in and out of the nucleus, and also it helps in communication between the cytoplasm and nucleus. So what are the substances that are being transported in and out of the nucleus? We know that these tRNAs, we need tRNA for translation, we need mRNA. mRNAs are being transcribed in the nucleus, and these mRNAs are then taken for translation for protein synthesis. So first the transcription process has to take place, and it takes place in the nucleus. As far as it is concerned, after the transcription, mRNA is synthesized, and these mRNAs has to be taken to the cytoplasm for the further translation process. So these mRNAs are transported from nucleus to cytoplasm through the nuclear pores. Likewise, other substances like tRNAs, which are also needed for translation, and the ribosomal subunits, which are synthesized in the nucleolus region, which we have already discussed in the previous videos. So that has to be also transported to the cytoplasm. So these things has to be transported to the cytoplasm, and all this transport occurs through the nuclear pore. And coming to the nuclear pore complex, let us see the detailed structure of a nuclear pore complex. Nuclear pores have an approximate size of 50 to 100 million daltons, and the electron microscopic studies revealed that nuclear pore complex, of course, is a complex structure, and it has two rings, an outer cytoplasmic ring. Here you can see in this structure there are two rings, an outer cytoplasmic ring and an inner nuclear ring. Okay, there are two rings, outer cytoplasmic and the inner nuclear ring. The central hole or the pore of the pore complex has water channels through which water soluble molecules are transported between the nucleus and the cytoplasm. Which is the hole? This is the hole. So through this is a water channel through this water soluble molecules are being transported. This hole is often plugged by a central plug. There is a central plug. This is the central plug. Okay, so these are the two rings, outer ring and inner ring, outer cytoplasmic and inner nuclear ring. So inside this there is a hole. You can see this, there is a hole, and this hole is plugged by this pink colored plug. This is the central plug, which regulates the movement of molecules. This is connected to the rings. The hole is plugged by a central plug that regulates the to and fro movement, and this is connected to the rings by radial spokes. So these are connected to the rings by a radial spokes. And the pore complex breaks the nuclear envelope lipid bilayer continuity. How? Because in this region where the pores are present, the nuclear membrane, the outer and the inner, they are not continuous. They break, and here they join, inner and outer join like this. So the continuity is broken by these pores. In majority of somatic cells, the nuclear pores are randomly distributed over the surface of nuclear membrane. And the specific arrangements or packing is noticed in some cell types. There is some specialities in their arrangement in some kind of cells. And regarding the density of the number of pores, the number of pores increases as the complexity of the cell increases. Or the cells which are more active metabolically, there will be more number of pores. And in case of mammals, there are enormous number of pores, nuclear pores. Pore density is determined by the transcriptional activity, the metabolic and transcriptional activity of the cell. If higher the metabolic activity, the number of pores, then the pore density will be higher also. then coming to the nucleoplasm. Nucleoplasm is nothing but the jelly-like matrix inside the nucleus. It is also called karyoplasm, and it helps the nucleus keep its shape and serves as the medium for the transportation of important molecules. It is like a protoplasm that is made up of water, a mixture of various molecules and dissolved ions. Like the same as cytoplasm, it is also a liquidy or fluid-like matrix. Then coming to nucleolus. Nucleolus is also functionally it is the ribosome factory. This is actually not a membrane-bound region inside the nucleus, but it is a actively transcribing granular region inside the nucleus. So it is not a separate entity, a membrane-bound separate entity. It is not a separate entity. It is not a separate membrane-bound entity, but it is the granular region seen inside the nucleus. It is seen as a granular region as it is actively transcribing region. Every nanosecond, there is transcription being happening in the nucleolar region. So that is why it is seen as a granular region when viewed at the right angle. But actually it is not a separate organelle-like body. It is not a separate body, it is separated by a membrane. It is only a granular region which is separated, seen separately because of the active transcription happening there. And it is a large prominent structure, doesn't have a membrane. Most cells have two or more nucleoles, and it is the region where the rRNAs are synthesized. Ribosomal RNAs are being synthesized, and the nucleolus takes up around 25% volume of the nucleus. It is made up of proteins and ribonucleic acids, and its function is ribosomal synthesis. Ribosomal subunits are synthesized in the nucleolar region. Functions: site for transcription, assemblage of ribosomes, synthesis of ribosomes, synthesis of RNAs. So that is all an overall about the structural details of nucleus. So hope you all understood. Thank you.